Yeah.
I know your eyes in the morning sun. I feel you touch me in the pouring rain. And the moment that you wander from me, I wanna feel you in my arms again. And you come to me on a summer breeze. Keep me warm in your love, then you softly, and it's me.
How deep is your love?
It's your love.
How deep is your love?
I really mean to love. Cause we living in a world full of walls, yeah. Breaking us down, yeah. When they all should let us be. We belong.
Hey, Imani. So we finally made it, a long journey, starting out from Towson, met you at Paws over some tater tots and ketchup, but we're here, and I'm happy to finally start the journey we've been setting up for so long. I think I wouldn't have asked for anyone better than you to have along my side as I grow old. I think one of the most important things that we've always shared with one another is, you know, making sure that the experiences count and that we're there for one another regardless of what we're going through individually or what we're going through as a couple. So I look forward to having you as my support and being there to support you. And hopefully we can raise a beautiful family and, you know, teach them how to enjoy the world the way that we do. I love you. Bye.
Charles, we made it to today. I know you're the only person who knows how hard it was for us to be here today together. I can't wait to see what life has in store for us. I love you. I know life is that much better with you in it, and I'm thankful to God every day that I have you as my blessing. Yay, I love you.
I believe in you.
Yeah.
And though the door to my bed was so, you're the light in my deepest, darkest hour. You're my savior when I fall.
I love you. I'm gonna leave you alone. I'm gonna make my back out of your room. See, like, I'm gonna. No. ينور العيني يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي حبيبي يا نور العيني يا ساكن خيالي عاشق بقالي سنين ولا غيرك في بالي
that Quran, right?
Well, thank you guys for your patience. This is the first wedding on both sides of the family for us, and I think we've done good so far. So at this point, we're going to open up with a prayer, and my dad is going to do that briefly.
It's now a short verse of the Quran. Since we come on this Muslim faith, we'll read the ayah as follows. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. Thank you all for understanding. Thank you all for the night.
Okay guys, so we're going to start with the dinner service. We ask that you guys be patient with our directions. We're trying to do it as efficient way as possible. So at first, we're going to start with the first four tables for the family members. So table, this table, that table, 1 through 4 on this side. Okay, the first three, right here. Same thing here, Awa. In the first three tables, please help yourself to some dinner. Okay, so left side is going to start. Left side is going to start first. The first three tables, please help yourself. Please get up and the dinner buffet is towards those doors. Self-serve. And when you guys get back, we'll have the next flow going. So in the meantime, please enjoy yourself to some music. Our great DJ Fields here, your friend of mine, which I'm really happy that he's able to do this. So please enjoy yourself and you can come for the dinner and we'll just leave the program after everyone has dinner.
Thank you. Yeah, so in Malawi, where we come from, can't just speak without being escorted and without a dance sort of practice of the mouth. Yeah, so good evening, everybody. I didn't hear that good evening from that corner. Good evening! Now I think we've eaten something enough to show that we have some energy. So I'm standing here, really, on behalf of Charles Kwame, Charles' mom, Judith. Judith, why don't you stand so people take a good look at you? For really doing such a wonderful job, bringing up Charles, Tawina, and Nadia. As many of you might know, Charles' dad passed on in 1997, and so all these years, really, she's taken care of the kids now, this grown-up man here. And so, really, it's just to thank her for the great work that she's done.
Thank you.
In Kenya, in Nairobi, and in Nairobi they have this Swahili way that they say somebody who plays the role that Judith has played, they call her Mama na Baba, because she's been the father and she's been the mother. So Judith, really, you've done a wonderful job. God continue blessing you, and I think really Charles will be the first one to really, I mean, my advice to Charles is the mother is the most important person, right? Apart from your wife, of course. So I think you know the drill. I think and Amani, I think we, as we welcome you to the Zulu family, I think we have a very very sweet sweet mother-in-law in Judith. I know you get along very very well, and I really wish you all the best. So Judith, actually, let me just Tawina is Charles' sister. Why don't you stand so people take a look at her? And there's some young girl. Nadia, where are you, Nadia? So really, Charles and Amani are from the Zulu family. We are very, very happy. We really thank God. We thank God for this huge blessing that we have today. Yesterday, we did the Nikah, the religious ceremony, and you could just feel it there where we did this, where the blessings were done. That, you know, your marriage really has huge blessings from above. So really urge you to continue trusting in God, to put God first, because really the foundation of any marriage has to be God. And we feel honored by what you, the two of you, have done. A lot of young people these days, you know, just start staying together and they start having children and stuff like that. But you've demonstrated to us that you've been respectful to the families, to the two families, by doing this really very honorable wedding and getting into your marriage. And you've honored God, you've honored our two cultures from both Somalia and Malawi. And for this, really, I want to thank you and ask you to continue, you know, with this spirit. There's the African culture that you need to respect. Actually, Charles, I want you to make a commitment to me that within the next 1 year, you are going to take your wife to Malawi, but also that you will go to Somalia to see where she comes from. There are a lot of witnesses here. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. So we need to go to Malawi and share where the Kampondos come from, where Judith, her parents came from. You know where your grandfather, your grandmother are there. They send their love, they send their greetings. Unfortunately, they couldn't come. Our own mother, we popularly call her Afala Ndilonge. Actually, she sent a video that I showed you yesterday, sending her love and her blessings to you. So if you need to keep, you need to know your family, and you need to continue, being part of the extended family. We come from a very, very big family. Actually, Amanda, I need to warn you about that, because you know that already, but let me state it for the others. Our own family, there were 11 children, one mother, and Judith came from also a family of 10 children. So when you really want to see our siblings, the children we've all had, some of them have had children, now we're going to the third line, and from her side, really it's a very, very big family, and we like doing things together. So as you come in, we welcome you to, you know, to be part of this family, to help expand this family, because we want it to be more formidable than this family. So I'm standing here to wish you two all the best, to wish you a happy marriage on behalf of people from our family. I am here myself with my wife, Alice. And our little girl there, Tenji. And also we have a friend who are here. He's my big brother Leo, who likes taking pictures and taking pictures. He's a professor in Michigan. In our case, actually, I shouldn't have been the one speaking here, because he's older than me. But they let me speak, partly because we kind of took a responsibility when Charles died, left us with my wife Alice, that we really wanted to be there for Charles. Charles came and stayed in Kenya with us for 3 years at some point in his life, and he came back here. So we really look at Charles as our own child in a way. And That's why I'm standing here. But really, as I end here, I think this would have been really a very, very proud day for your dad, Charles. It's been, 20 years now since he went. I think looking at you, the man you've grown into, he would have been very, very proud, and I think he would have been welcoming a man very, very, warmly. And we are doing this on his behalf. And for you to know that Charles' dad may not be there, but he has Charles has fathers. They are there. We pray the father figure, and if there are any issues. I met Amani's dad about more than a year ago, as we were talking about, hey, these young people say they are in love. You know? What does this mean in the larger scheme of life? And so we had a 3-hour... dinner. Charles joined us, and then we kicked him out and said, "No, now the elders need to talk." And I talked with him, and I think for us, our discussion was really about marriage is not just about love. Love alone can't put food on the table, and there's no shortcut to life. You have to put in the hours. You have to work hard. You have to work together as husband and wife. You need to continue being friends, because if you are not friends, then, you know, this marriage can't really go very, very far. God has blessed you. God has brought us this far, has brought you this far. I think you need to keep the faith. You need to keep the love that you have, continue burning. You need to be friends, and you need to do things together. And if you work hard, I think everybody here has worked hard, there will be testimony to this. There's no shortcut. You have to work hard. You have to work together. So I think the indications we've seen so far, you guys stuck to it and say, we love each other, we'll get it done. I think it's going to happen, and we're going to, we really wish you all the best as you enter into this new life as a Mr. and Mrs. Zulu, right? We'll see with time whether Amani will change her name, but no pressure. All right, so as I end now, this is not meant to be long, but I just want to thank everybody who has come here. I think one of the greatest things that you guys have done now is that you've united the two communities, the two families, even I can say the two countries, Somalia, Malawi, the family of Amani and our own family. So the family has grown bigger because now we are together as one. So I'd like to thank really everybody who is here from Charles' side, Charles' mom's side. There are a lot of friends here. Some who live here, Malawians. Some have come all the way from Malawi. Who has come the farthest here? Some from Canada, some from Kenya. I think Malawi is further than Kenya. Who has come here from Malawi, that the family there say, at least one person should come from Malawi to be at this wedding. But there are a lot of people who have come from all over the world to be here, and we don't take this for granted. You could have all been doing something else out there. This ceremony is this good, and I think it's just starting. We're gonna all sweat out here. If we go by what happened yesterday, I think we'll dance quite a lot. So let's continue enjoying this. Thank you a lot for coming. Thank you a lot, Mohammed, and also Mohammed's brother, Abdullah. He lives in Nairobi. We also had a meeting in Nairobi to talk about, you know, this whole thing. He was explaining to me about the culture. So really, we come together as two big families joining together. And for us, we can't wait really to be there for you guys. And thanks a lot, everybody, for sparing your time. Thanks a lot for being here. God bless you. Thanks, Charles.
That there was a love that was cooking underneath,
But they didn't tell me because they were afraid it's two different cultures, it's two different people. And Charles, even though he is more American and Amani is more American, they were grown here. I mean, they came young, both of them, and they are more American than any of our own black home cultures in Africa. But even though we have, you know, we all married within the Somali community, if it's possible, and Malawians, of course, and I can tell, you all marry within yourselves, and that's normal. Just to you know, why is that? And anyone can ask you, why is that? It's normal. I mean, our forefathers, you know, has thought about this. When you marry someone that you know, if anything happens, because it says, you know, people say in history that you can bite your tongue, but then the saliva of your mouth heals your wound. That means if you know someone who is close by, who is a friend, maybe or your tribe, or someone who is you know, not far distance from your area, at least you know their family and their family members around you. If it happens, anything happens, you can go back to them, to the elders, and then resolve the problem before they can grow. This was really a wise idea from our forefathers, and we have taken from them. But honestly, love has conquered all of it. We know that love takes over. What I came to know is these two individuals are in love, and they want to have life together. I could not stop them from my side. None of them were, you know, hesitating from to have the other person. And I said, okay, why should I be on a sacrifice for this? Are you okay? So, and then I came to know that they have the same faith. Now, maybe some of you in Malawi from the Malawi culture may think, okay, he was born Christian. Why? What happened? Did he have to convert to Islam in order to marry Amani? That's not the case. This young man has chosen, he's an old guy now, he has chosen his faith by himself. And I have witnesses of his friends here at Carlton University, and they met at the MSA, which is the Muslim Community Association, which Amani and himself and his friends were working on. And at the university, there are students who usually do the hard work, and both of them did that. And that's how I came to know Charles. A lovely man, a young man. Let me talk back to my daughter's profile. My daughter, because I love this man. I really do. He's my son. He's now my son-in-law. I know his father passed away, and he has also uncles and mom. But I am now filling out his father-in-law. I can have that title. Amani showed me. Amani is in the middle, and we call in our culture. Anybody who is in the middle is the wisest and the best person, obviously. I don't want to stop my doors. But I wanna make a shout. I wanna shout out for all of them. I wanna send Ilan, where are you, Ilan? She's the eldest of all. Sister is that lovely lady who is Maureen. And we have number three, of course, the bride. And Basma is my youngest daughter. And we have a man in the house who is now, I want to mention my 35 years of love here. I cannot leave this microphone without mentioning her and her sacrifice with me to these young boys and girls. I think I know if she had raised four girls, one son, which is obviously you can tell why he is the last person. We've been looking for him for quite some time. And Bosman is lucky, the last two girls to be alive, because if he would have come in number three. So, you must thank, you know, all these two ladies, who came before. You must thank them, because Elias came late. Now, conclude with the family members who are here. There are aunties. We have our grandmom here, who is our Marine. Our grandma, she is the friend of life friend of my wife's mom, who passed away in 1998. Obviously, she has been with her for a long time, and now she is the mother figure for my wife, who is around here in Maryland, Virginia. I have also the aunts who are the sisters of sister-in-law on the left, Halima, and Rao. Can you stand up, please? I don't want to mention again more than necessary. Abdullahi, he was a minister a couple of years ago in Somalia. I can even see he looks like me, and nobody mixed with anybody. Professor Abbas, you mentioned the professor. We have our own professor here. Abbas, Abdullah, stand up, Abdullah. It's 35 years, maybe close to 36. He was my friend for a long time. When we got married, we befriended, and we still friends. And thank God, we moved every year, time we moved from one country to another. You know, we're all being immigrants, and we came at some point. We came to the same state with the same area. That's how we've been friends. We have also family, relatives that are... I want you to all stand up one time, please, if you can, if I haven't mentioned your name. All the relatives. Yeah, so in order to complete the profile, Amani has been my lovely daughter in terms of school. I never had any struggle from her. Everybody struggles with their children, but the best person who made my life easier in school throughout all the standards of school, in terms of the lowest level to the highest, now she's doing her master's and possibly closing it in the spring next year, was Amani. I have to give another scene to this young man. Okay, so you have a lovely person, and I know you will do well. I'm your father, and I'm also your father. And I will be watching you both, and I hope I will bless you every time. I pray for you. And if you need to have any resource, it's me, and obviously it's your family. Thank you, Mama Zulu, to have to give us this young, lovely, handsome man. Thank you all, thank you for coming here, and I appreciate this moment to speak about my family. I'll make it short, and thank you so much.
Sorry, so I want to fix something. I forgot to really introduce some very, very critical people who have played a role in Charles' life as well. There's Charles' uncle, Judith's brother, Aubrey, and his wife, Patricia. Please just be acknowledged. And there's Tandy, Judith's sister as well. Around Charles, and I think I didn't talk about Charles at all, but I just wanted to say one key thing. Charles, since the dad went, he's been the father figure in the family. He's a very, very humble person. He's been a very, very caring think Charles, one of the maybe problems I feel he has in life is that sometimes he's too good to people to his own detriment because he wants to put other people first. So I think you are getting a very, very good man. Not only that he's handsome, but I think he has a good heart. I would like to be like that.
Thank you guys so much. Thanks, Dad, for that lovely speech. Clearly, both of my families are hilarious. So, next comic show will be on Thanksgiving, I assume. But right now, I just wanted to share a few words to my sister and mother.
Some secrets for them, for Mommy, I will.
I'm sorry, I'm so bad. But congratulations. So at this point, we're going to transition over to the next part of the program.
Charles' only sister until Nadia came 13 years later, so I feel like I had to just say something really fast. I guess I want to share one quick story to share. Just like, my brother has always been like, anybody who's close to me knows he was my first best friend. He's like my twin. We're very close in age. We're only 3 years apart. So even growing up, it was like, couldn't tell us apart even though it was a boy and a girl next to each other. And so he was my first example for a lot of things, a lot of characteristics that I admire in other people. He's the first kind heart I've known. He's the first loyal person I've known. So to say that, I'm gonna share a quick story. It's more embarrassing on my part than on his, but we'll back around. So like when I was a kid, he was the first person I shared a room with. He was my first sibling. So when I was 3, he was 6, we would share the room together. And that was the time where I was like leaning off of like, I guess being potty trained. So I used to like have nightmares as well. So every time I would have a nightmare, he would let me get in his bed and we would just sleep together. And then I would end up peeing in the bed. And no matter what, even after he would wake me up and he's like, did it again. And then after, the bed would get cleaned, and he would still let me get back in the bed. It was so amazing. Like, how many times do I have to pee? I'm gonna... Okay, how many times do I have to pee in the bed? Like, and it just never failed. Like, I always had the companion. Be my buddy up here. He can stay. He's great company. So with that story, I just say like he's been like that, very consistent. He's been the first loyal person. I was more of the wild one between the two of us. I think I gave my mom a bit more of a headache. That gave, like, he was the translator for her. You know, when you go through the awkward phase, you're a teenager, your parents are trying to give you wisdom, and you're like not trying to hear it, he would say the same things like, turn the other cheek. It's okay. And I'm like, okay, why? But he was always that person. He was always the kind heart. So when I met Imani, it was like, wow, how could you meet like someone that's like sweeter than you, genuinely, you know? It's like, me and her are the same age, so we're age mates as well, and we just clicked. Not only that, but we all grew up in the same area, the same, not even just county, but like, same 5 miles of a block. And half of us didn't know each other, but we know each other in reference of schools. I have some of her childhood friends are people that I went to school with and I was friends with. So us coming together was like, it was just like meant to be, like it was no other way. You know, like we share friends and he's just, both of them, they're a reflection of each other. Both of them share loyalty. You could sell by all of Imani's thousands of friends, her endless plethora of friends that she just goes out loving everyone. And then Charles is kind heart and just very quiet spirit. And they're both very loyal people, so I couldn't imagine anybody else other than her to be his wife. So I'm very happy.
Thank you.
I should say Texas. So we're going to transition now to the next part, which is the cake cutting. We ask that you guys give a little bit of space for the photographers and video to capture the moment. But otherwise, feel free to stand up, take pictures, clap it up for the lovely couple to cut their cake together.
I feel the time. Hey guys, so at this point, we're going to briefly just introduce the fact that we're going to represent both cultures and their traditional musical songs. So first, we're going to start with the Malawi culture. So
everybody. Star love, I love you. Cause I can't win. I feel to marry you. I feel to marry you, Nana. I feel to give you love. I feel to show you love. I want to marry you, Nana. I want to marry you, yeah. I feel to give you love. I go to East and West just to find my love. I go to North and South just to find my love. No, they play with my love. I beg no play with my love. Cause I cannot be gentleman. But I'm gonna show you love. All that girl step inside the water, side the water. Mommy, now you be the realest. Anything I tell you, say, mommy, no be lamba. Now you be the realest. Timba, 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 sope. When you go sope, sope. Tolu, bola, fola, shade. Ole, mi mo, vibe, imbe. I feel to marry you. I feel to marry you, Nana. I feel to give you love. I feel to show you love. I want to marry you now. I want to marry you, yeah. I feel to give you love. Girl, you know your body now. I swear, I no go let you go. Girl, you know your body now. I swear, I no go leave you. Mommy bad back, I don't know silicon. No, 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 no. Mommy nice, mommy cute, you touching me on. I no go let you go. Can't you see that I love you? But what you shame me? Can't you see that I need you? That come and feel me. Timba, timba, timba. I feel to marry you. I feel to marry you, Nana. I feel to give you love. I feel to show you love. I want to marry you, Nana. I want to marry you, yeah. I feel to give you love.
Jules, baby.
Thank you guys so much.
sort of effort it takes to get this sort of thing done. So Uncle Leah, Uncle Alice, Uncle Leo, Uncle Aubrey, Uncle Patricia, Jane, everybody on Chantunya, everybody who's here has helped in some way or another to make this happen. Papa Bisley, Mama Layla, thank you so much for everything that you've done. I think everything has gone flawlessly, and we appreciate everything that you guys are doing for us, and all the kind words that you had to say. I didn't realize I had all those qualities until you guys brought them up. Maybe, but no. Thank you guys so much. I'm happy that we are starting our union off on such a good foot. We've been friends for a long time, as you guys have heard, and we've been working towards this for a long time. And I think for the both of us, until it started happening, it was so surreal. Transition is seamless, but the things that we've gained, the knowledge we've gained, the family, the friends, couldn't dream it for the world. Thank you so much.
I don't know how I'm supposed to top that, but I just want to start out and say Alhamdulillah. I couldn't begin to tell you how happy my soul is. My soul is full, and it's full with love from all of you. And I'm not going to cry. I did that yesterday. So I just want to take a moment to first start out and say thank you to people that you might know as vendors that are not vendors. If you are one of those people who have quickly turned into family, could you please come forward? Come here.
By now you are my son, even though that is in law, and you made a choice to be my son-in-law by marrying my lovely daughter Amani. Amani, I will keep cherishing you, keep loving you, Abo, and keep being your Abo for a long time, as long as I live. Thank you, Abriel. Thank you, Aral. Thank you for. And so, as you can see, that it's noisy and people are dancing and loving it. Yesterday, you had your nikah. Both of you, your nikah happened to be exemplary. People are asking how this happened. It was very lovely and it was managed well. And the topping of the cake was adding it up with the send-off. The send-off in Somali means sending actually the couple and the people off to their life. You are on your own, that's what it means. You are now a couple, that's what it means. I am hoping that you recognize the moment tonight that your wedding and reception has ended, and in loving fashion and with both families and extended families watching and witnessing an excellent setup place and an excellent setup, you know, time for this. You have called a good professional crew also for taking pictures, videos, and everything else, and the songs obviously, and everything is loving. I will hope that in life, if you find any bumps, don't be shocked, because that's when you know, you will be tested. I have been tested 35 years with your mother Amani, and indeed we have excelled and we have sailed the waters and the high waters in fashion, in good fashion. And if you have any hiccups, Abo, please ask your mother and your father for help. You know, same thing, some talk on Charles. If you find yourself that you need a father figure, because I'm your father-in-law now, if you need an advice, whatever it is, please talk to me. Don't hesitate to explain to what it is to me, and I'll be happy to give you that advice wholeheartedly. And I hope that you will have both of you sons and daughters that love you, and you can make boys and girls for us, and also you will have a loving life between you, educated people, as well as healthy. And I'm hoping that in life you will have mercy for each other and patience for each other. That's a challenge. Don't be aware of anything in life that you will never ever make a mistake. Remember, if you make a mistake, I made a mistake, but I solved it. Amani, if you make a mistake, please remember that your mom made a mistake and she resolved it. Please be patient for your husband. Make sure you are the interior minister of your home and he is the exterior minister, foreign minister of the house and the family. Thank you so very much. I will hope and pray for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the forgiving. Please pray your prayers. Please do your faith properly. And thank you very much for setting up this lovely place. And we have been delighted, both families. Thank you for enlarging our family.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And Amani, and I wanna speak with in Somali language. In the future, you translate your husband. Oyo, I love you too much. And I wanna say you in ninkaaga ka dambay reerkaaga dhaqo naaga hayay ku sheekeynin waqtigaaga iska dhuminin. That is my advice for you.
Hey Amani, hey Charles, this is your mom. Just wanting to say nothing much really. I've already said all I can say, you know already. I'm just wishing you well. I'm wishing you all the best. Whatever you do, wherever you are, just keep on loving each other. That's all. That's all that matters. Keep looking out for each other's backs, and then you'll be okay. Everything will be okay. And always fear God. Put God first in your lives, and everything will be good. We love you. I love you so much. And I'm wishing you all the best, all the time. Love you lots. Thank you. Bye.
Hey, Charles and Amani, we want to congratulate you both. We're very proud of you. And this, our family is getting bigger, and we look forward to having you in the family.
Yeah, so really, Amani, welcome to the family. Take care of business, Charles. We wish you all the best, you know. This is really one of the proudest moments in our family. You know, your dad could have been prouder than we are proud, but this is really great. We thank God for the blessings that God has bestowed on you. Keep the faith.
Yeah, and we have family at home too, your grandparents, your aunts, and your nephews. They all wish you really well. They wish you the best. And we are, the sky's the limit. We are excited about the possibilities, and we just ask for God's blessing for your future.
All right.
All right. Okay.
Charles Amani, I've known you guys as a couple for my whole life. Feels like it. You guys are relationship goals. I've come to you whenever I've needed any type of advice, and you guys are always there for me. Charles, you're a real one, and we know the backstory to that. There's no doubt about it. You throw punches when I need you to throw punches. You got my back, and I'll forever get your back too.
Hey, Charles, Amani. Yeah, I know I'm a man of a few words, but I just wanted to take the time to say a few, share a few things with y'all. Amani, you've been one of my best friends since we were 12 years old. Charles, I am beyond ecstatic to officially call you my brother now. There's nobody else in the world that I would rather have with Amani than you, bruh. I'm so excited to be here. Hey, you're standing right there. You're not gonna see this till later on, but you're standing right next to me as I'm saying this, so it's kind of meta right now. Anywho, I love you both so dearly. Just remember wise words my mom told me when I was a kid, a happy wife is a happy life. So I love y'all. I wish you all nothing but love and joy and happiness and peace and prosperity and the rest of your days together. May Allah just bless you.
Not because of you, eh, I get to go strong. All over, all over. This feeling got me falling. All over, all over. Get out, there's something they do me for body, yo. All over, all over. I make you make me spend this money, yo. All over, all over. Not because of you, eh, I get to go strong. All over, all over. This feeling got me falling. All over, all over. Get out, there's something they do me for body, yo. All over, all over. I make you make me spend this money, oh.